My name is Huma Adnan and my brand is called Funkasia. The brand came about 12 years ago when I was in search of craft from Pakistan, and that's how I invented this brand, which actually talks about fusion wear in Pakistan, and it creates fashion keeping in mind the values and traditions of Pakistan. Recently I have joined hands with UNHCR and I'm working with them to do vocational training with the refugees living in Pakistan. There are 1.4 million refugees alone in Pakistan and 50,000 just in Karachi, which are the registered ones. So I was, in fact, today only I got a confirmation from who's next. This is a trade fair in Paris that takes place twice a year. I'm sure you would know about it. So they were very impressed by what I'm doing, because for 2020 the theme for fashion is sustainable fashion, positive fashion, and that's exactly what I'm doing here in Pakistan. So I'm training refugees living in Karachi at the moment to make handicraft jewelry. I'm actually wearing a piece from the refugees at the moment. So this is the jewelry that I would like the French to have a look at the trade fair. And there'll be actually visitors from all over the world. There are lots of buyers that come because I feel that these refugees need to become sustainable, need to, and fashion needs to be sustainable more than anything. I think we really need to think about people who have the talent, but yet they're ignored. And this is what I do besides my own brand. So I do a lot of this work, keeping in mind the sustainability of a project. Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Exactly 30 years ago, I used to be a corporate banker. And that's when I realized that Pakistan is an agrarian country and our largest produce is textiles. But we were exporting raw cotton, yarn, and the maximum value addition we could offer was textile made-ups, like just side-stitched bed sheets and pillowcases. And that's when I realized that the highest value addition offered to the textile industry are fashion garments. And I decided that I should really get into fashion designing if I want to make a difference in this country. And I gave up banking and I decided to be a fashion designer. So the closest product I could find, not being a trained fashion designer, was making neckties, because I used to wear one every day. So I started designing flashy neckties and I held an exhibition and started selling them. So in exactly December 1990, I gave up my job and I decided to be a fashion designer, or start an enterprise based on fashion. Not only I faced mockery, ridicule, I was shunned out of my friend's circle, but my parents nearly threw me out of the house and said, "This is what we educated you for, you now want to become a tailor." This was then. But 30 years down the road, just the fact that I'm sitting here representing an industry which that has grown into shows the kind of progress fashion has made in Pakistan. Just a few other comparisons. When I wanted to become a fashion designer, of course I wanted to be trained, like Shumail rightly said. But there weren't any fashion schools. In fact, fashion wasn't even considered a career. I was called a tailor right through. It was a bored housewife's profession who had a lot of money and just wanted to enjoy sitting at home and wanted social acceptance. They would become fashion designers. But fashion designing was never considered serious business. So when I got into it, I wanted to train myself, but there weren't any schools. And that was a challenge, a very big challenge that I faced. But 4 years later, Pakistan School of Fashion Design was formed. Mr. Bhatti was an instrumental force in that, and all of us were part of it. We went to Paris and we got the franchise and all. And now, more than 2,000 fashion graduates have been turned out by that school. And there's another school in Karachi called Asian Institute of Fashion Design, and they've turned out about 1,000 fashion designers. So in the last 25 years or so, we have more than 3,000 qualified trained fashion designers who are contributing towards this industry. And you all realize, for any industry to grow, the best resource is humans. And if they're qualified and trained, of course they would add professionalism to it. Another thing happened around the same time. We wanted to form fashion councils to represent fashion designers. So I was on the board of all the fashion councils, all of us were. So the first thing I suggested to the people who were founding it, that everybody who is going to participate needs to have a national tax number and we need to be registered taxpayers. And the first response was, taxes? You want us to pay taxes? You want tax inspectors to come into our houses? We're not going to pay taxes. Who pays taxes? We work out of our houses and you talk about taxes. Today, the FBR has published a list of 48 top retailers in the country that are integrated with FBR in terms of the revenue declaration and paying of sales tax. And more than 20 of them are fashion labels. I'm one of them also. So this is the kind of growth this industry has seen. I would call it an industry very proudly, and I think this is one of the most needed industries in Pakistan because the largest produce, being textile, needs to get the maximum value addition. I'm also told by some sources that there are now more than 60 brands registered which are selling fashion garments in Pakistan, and they are generating roughly 3 billion rupees of revenue on which they're paying sales tax, about 14%. So I think fashion is now developing into a very well-recognized industry, and it is all poised to grow to a large scale and definitely make inroads into the rest of the world. I hope that happens. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Sarah Paracha, and I'm the publisher of OK Magazine in Pakistan. And basically, I launched this magazine about 5 years ago to promote a brighter and more positive side of the country and sort of focus on all these, you know, amazing artists and talented designers and sports personalities and philanthropists and all the amazing talent and amazing things that this country has to offer. Thank you.
Yeah.
Can I give a suggestion to that?
Please. Yeah.
You said what needs to be done next. We need to collaborate. We need to collaborate together, fashion designers, textile manufacturers, and large-scale garment manufacturers. Way back, I would say about 60 years ago, 50 years ago, Giorgio Armani, you all have heard his name. He started off, he was a very good, enterprising fashion designer, but he did not have the resources to make his label big. He collaborated with two giants. There was a textile manufacturer, and there was a garment manufacturer. So they formed a company where Armani owned 10% of the shares, and the remaining 90% was split half and half between the textile manufacturer and the garment manufacturer. And that's how they started off. Look where his label has reached today, and the kind of revenue and the kind of business he generates is phenomenal. And that's exactly what Pakistan needs. Textile manufacturers, large-scale textile manufacturers, need to collaborate with fashion designers to bring in more value addition to their raw material that they're producing. And large-scale manufacturers need to produce high-quality garments, which would not only saturate the local market, and because Pakistan is a huge has a huge domestic market with the kind of population we have and the growing discretionary income, and more people working, they have less time to go to tailors and have their garments stitched. So people are now moving towards ready-made garments, and that's where fashion starts. So first, we need to create these collaborations so that Pakistan itself can benefit from better quality, high value addition garments, and once that is done, then exports would follow. So first it's like, you know, import saturation and then exports.
I also have one more suggestion, is that I worked years ago with the House of Lesage, which was set up in, which was in China, which is also in France, which is also in India, and it was all about handcraft. Today, if anybody wants to import hand embroideries or get value addition products made, Pakistan is economically the most reasonable country, the most reasonable prices for handcraft. So this is something where I agree with Adnan, that we need to, designers need to combine with factories, with textile mills, so that our exports can really gain the value addition very soon.
We've already seen an example of this in the lawn industry. A lot of lawn is consumed, that's very thin fabric which women wear. It used to be sold everywhere but at a low value. But then designers rendered their designs and their names onto the fabric. And then now a designer lawn is sold at 10 times the value that it used to a few years ago.
So that's what I mean by collaboration. But that was just loose fabric. Now we need to collaborate and produce off-the-shelf garments, ready-made products, and then higher value addition products. So that's the way forward.
Okay, thank you very much, panelists. We are really indebted to you for being here. So kindly take your seats. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Excellency, may I request you for a moment to present an award to Mr. Mahmood Bhatti. Thank you.
Thank you. Shukriya.